I'm now going out to do a quick update. What? What is it, you? Do you want some foodies, Elfin Cat? Oh, you don't like the camera. What is it? Huh? I'm doing a quick update. Yeah, you come and help me. Elfin is she's a special Pyrenees breed of sort of mountain cat. That was her saying hello. If you have space, it's always a good idea to maybe get locally a couple of straw bales that you can sit on or use in the garden. And now, just as I start, I've got someone's cutting grass or something, I don't know. So here, I planted, I don't know, I just threw seeds in. That's probably Chinese cabbage or mini bok choy or something. And it is now April 30th, 2018. And what you see here is that the straw has now, with the rain, has made a compost-like structure on top of the soil that protects against all weathers, excess rain, excess heat. And now the celery's coming back to life. And a few of I threw in before I left some peas, I think sugar snap peas, and they're coming up now really fast. And the celery is taking off. And so basically what you can do is, my Swiss chard has bolted, but that's okay because I can gather the seeds and make lots more Swiss chard and just eat the rest. I don't know what this is. This is a surprise. Well, what I got here was, oh yeah, I replanted the stinging nettle, which I want for various reasons. I mean, they can be used in so many ways, not only in the garden, but as tea or in salads or just added to soup. And I was quite surprised to see that I'm getting now stinging nettle colonies, which was totally absent from the garden. Absolutely 100% dried out soil with no nutrition. And now this to me is a sign of health, that the stinging nettle comes. A lot of people don't like them. They will pull them out. They see them as an invasive species. But to be honest, they're an indicator of plant health. And so it's sort of like basically along the lines of permaculture, natural companion herbs and plants like this, as long as they don't get out of control, will benefit the other plants in the garden. And then what I did was I just threw in, I planted garlic, I planted onions, mini tiny baby onions. And I don't know what this is. I mean, this potentially is some kind of Chinese cabbage. I put seeds in. It smells fantastic. I have to check it out. All the necessary insects. And the bees, of course. And it's just so aromatic. And it's a benefit to plant and human life and insect life. Where are you, little insect? Another one. Somewhere here. And they just are drinking it up. Now, I did plant this. And within just a few weeks, it's just unbelievable. And I have to find out what it is. And in the back, I did lots of more sugar snap peas. I just put them against the wall. And I've got a little bamboo frame. And what I'm trying to say to people is, This is not a gardening channel, and this is not a gardening video. This is good for humans. If you have any small space, this is why I'm doing it in this small space. I mean, if I wanted, I could be doing some sort of garden area, sort of land garden. But what I want to do is I want to show people who don't normally garden and who wouldn't put a plant into the soil and don't know how to, and maybe their garden is, they have absolutely rubbish soil, which this was, just hardened, sandy, stony construction. And it's a benefit beyond the food. We're not doing this for food. This is a benefit to the human mind, to the human psyche. It's just individual. You can't put it into a, you can't explain it or put it into a program and say to people, these are the benefits you get, or this is why to do it. Because everyone's different, everyone is unique. And it's a learning process. Sometimes it fails, things won't work. But one thing I can tell you is if you're going to do some little tiny area and just try to plant things, this is the most beneficial way to do it if you want to get it going and you want it to work, and that is straw. And I will put another layer down before I leave. This is now becoming a sort of compost and creating beneficial soil bacteria and microbes, and it's breaking down, and it's so easy to do, and it's a lot of fun. And there are my sugar snap peas, and that's going to be fun later.